Here's your WNEM TV5 news update.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Meg McLeod. Among our top stories, trepidation and elation over Michigan lifting its mask mandate.
I'm excited, but I have to admit I'm a little nervous about it.
I think it's fantastic. It's about time we opened the state back up and got back to normal.
The state is aligning itself with the CDC's new guidance. The welcome news comes on a day the state reported fewer than 1,800 new cases of COVID. This right here is a color-coded chart from the CDC. The right-hand column for vaccinated people is green all the way down. In every scenario, no mask is necessary.
The data is clear. The COVID-19 vaccines are a miracle of modern science.
To date, Michigan has administered more than 7.8 million vaccines. The new state order takes effect tomorrow morning at 9. Continuing coverage, a businessman has been sentenced for dumping nearly 48 million gallons of untreated landfill wastewater into the Flint sewer system. Robert Massey, the president and owner of Oil Chem Incorporated on West 12th Street, was charged with violating the Clean Water Act. Federal prosecutors say the dumping occurred over a period of more than 8 years. Massey was sentenced to a year. Authorities have announced two arrests in a hit and run that critically injured a teenage girl. 19-year-old Ian Adams is charged with failure to stop at the scene of an accident and other felonies. And 19-year-old James Rhodes III is facing accessory after the fact and other charges. The 15-year-old victim was struck the evening of May 2nd on West Pearson near DuPont. Investigators say they soon expect to arrest a third suspect. And now here's Brian with a look at our forecast.
All right, thanks very much, Meg. Heading into the upcoming weekend, our weather continuing to look very nice, staying on the warm side, most importantly, although there will be the increasing chance, especially on Sunday, for some scattered showers. On the first 1-5 Sky Tracker tonight, we have high pressure still centered just south of the state over Ohio. That'll begin to park itself over Pennsylvania as we head into Saturday. So over the next 24 hours, the general weather pattern will not exhibit too much change. Heading into Sunday, Saturday night and Sunday is when things are going to start to change because we see this elongated disturbance, a pair of low pressure systems, one over Minnesota and one into eastern parts of Nebraska. That will begin to spread our way Saturday night and into Sunday, bringing us more cloud coverage for the second half of the weekend. And also a better chance for some scattered showers. So first 1-5 hour by hour forecast taking you from 8 o'clock this evening into the midnight hour. The big change is just going to be that we're going to lose the daytime heating and also most of the clouds and any of those showers that have been trying to bubble up this afternoon. Heading on into the overnight period, we'll continue to see a mix of clouds and clear skies, I should say, leading to similar sky conditions as we wake up first thing tomorrow morning. Not much change through the midday period, although even at times on Saturday with the daytime heating clouds that bubble up, you know, we may briefly settle into a more mostly cloudy interval or two here and there. Afternoon hours around 3 o'clock, we'll begin to see some of those spotty showers bubbling up here and there again into early tomorrow evening. One or two of those may have a slightly heavier downpour with it. But unlike the last couple of evenings where we lose a lot of the clouds and the chance for showers in the evening, into tomorrow night, we're only going to keep the shower threat around, light though they will be, as that disturbance begins to spread in from the west. Light showers will be possible even as we're getting up on Sunday morning, but a better chance will come during the afternoon with the disturbance overhead, a breakup of the clouds and some daytime heating. Some of the showers, as you see here on Sunday afternoon, could be more widespread, but I do not expect our Sunday, regardless, to be a washout. Most importantly here in the near term tonight, no frost to worry about. Low temperatures staying in the 40s, 46 around the Tri-Cities and Flint under partly cloudy skies. And another winter tomorrow, sun and clouds, spotty shower possible in the afternoon, but a high around 73 degrees. And we hold that level and in fact see things warm up even more as we look ahead to next week. We'll stay in the low 70s both days for the upcoming weekend. Mid 70s on Monday and Tuesday. Upper 70s on Wednesday and Thursday when the chance for a few thunderstorms returns, and we'll hover in those mid 70s with more storms possible on Friday.
Remember to tune into WNEM TV5 on air and online 24/7 for the latest news, weather, and information.